All right, hello guys, and welcome to today's podcast. We were hoping for a low-key discussion about Russia, but Uncle Putin ko kuch chain nahi pad raha hai. Uncle Putin got no chill. So we'll have to discuss what is going on over the last 24 hours with respect to Russia and Ukraine. So we'll delve into a little bit into it a little bit. Abhijit, I know, has to run in a little while, so we'll do our Russia discussion, and then we'll do some memes. We'll try and avoid memes based in Russia, because just going by what is going on right now, how this conflict develops, we want to make sure that hasna hai to hasna hai, but phaltugiri nahi karni hai. So we want to be sensitive towards that as well. So let's first at least try to get an understanding of what is going on. And I want to start with Jambu Lakshmi Dande Yutham. And I want to ask Jambu Lakshmi...
Dande Yutham.
Dandai? Abhe,
achha, dandai ki dand hai,
bhe. Double A dalna?
Haan, toh double A dalna padega na.
Kyo?
Mara galti thodi hai.
Kyo?
When is dand is not danda.
It's not dandi. I haven't put... I've added an A, no? I've not put... D-A-N-D-Y.
वो ऊपर डालना पड़ेगा हाँ वो
नहीं कुछ नहीं दंडायुधम
अच्छा ठीक है दंडायुधम तो दंडायुधम जी पहले ये बताइए कि so what is the current situation in Russia because as far as we knew the latest thing that had happened before this conflict escalated is Putin had come out and done a press conference where he had blamed Ukraine of being pro NATO and presenting a threat to sovereignty of Russia, security of Russia. They said that, the Ukrainian government was full of Nazis and all of that, and the NATO was supporting Nazis. And as a result of that, they said ki theek hai, hum jo do pro-Russian districts hain, ab areas hain, Ukraine mein, Donetsk and I think Luhansk, we will support those two areas. That was the last thing that he said. And then suddenly... if reports can be believed, there's a full-scale invasion going on where there's bombing in basically every part of Ukraine right now. And there's news of, you also reported on it, that there's news of Russian ground invasion and Belarusian ground invasion into Ukraine as well. So what is the current status of the entire thing?
So the current status is that they've come very close to Kiev, Russian ground forces. They've taken over a city called what's basically a suburb. Jaise Delhi ka Gurgaon hai na, waise Kiev ka Gostomel hai. Achha. They've taken that over. They've captured Kiev airport. Okay.
Achha.
And that's something like about 120, 150 kilometers away from the Russian border, much closer to the Belarusian border. So I don't know where the troops came into possibly from Belarus to hit Kiev.
Yeah.
But all the big cities are now, there is some form of a Soviet ground, a Russian ground troops operating within.
Yeah.
Okay. The resistance that we're seeing is non-existent. They are, if you saw the ambassador to India, and if you've even seen the president of Ukraine, they are distraught. They are completely distraught. They literally never thought it was going to come to this. And to be honest, neither did I. And amazingly, neither did my friends in Moscow. They are stunned. They're very, very afraid of what's going to happen because they don't know what is going to happen tomorrow with their future and the future of their kids. Because, see, they never signed up to grow up in an isolated country that is heavily sanctioned.
Right.
Okay. So, I honestly don't know what Putin was thinking. None of them seem to know what the hell Putin was thinking on this.
There is a lot of talk
because,
about...
there is no logic. There's no logic. He could have achieved everything he wanted, which was a defanged, demilitarized Ukraine, if he just continued doing the same thing for about 2-3 maybe 5 years. You know, it would have destroyed the Ukrainian economy. There would have been huge turmoil within Ukraine. And invariably, they would have gotten to the stage where, you know, they throw up their hands in the air and say, okay, we'll just leave us alone. Please, we will go neutral. We won't be in your orbit, but we won't go into Western orbit. We swear neutrality, and we'll have a sort of free trade agreement with you and free movement agreement with you and all of that. Okay. They didn't, mostly because NATO was bhadkaofying them from the back, saying karo, 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 karo. Right. So it's just one of those things where you really don't know what can happen now.
So talk to us a little bit about that NATO's role in this situation as well, because a lot of people are talking about how this situation probably wouldn't have materialized. Jo abhi ho raha hai. On the one hand, obviously, what you've said, I completely understand that it seems like a bit of an overreach and an overreaction by Putin. On the other hand, there are some people that are also saying this situation would not have materialized today if NATO and the US and its allies hadn't participated in the Maidan Revolution in 2014 and ousted the previous regime and installed what is essentially a puppet regime of EU and NATO in Ukraine today. How much stock do you place in that?
I completely buy that 100% because I've seen this. Remember, I spent a wonderful part of my childhood in Moscow when it was the USSR. I still have a lot of my very close friends still live in Moscow. They're members of the government. The basic thing was, if you look, go back and see Putin's speeches on this in 2000-2001. He says, look, if countries want to join NATO, ye unka haq banta hai, join karo. We ourselves want to have a very good relationship with NATO.
Okay.
But what suddenly happened to, from there, within 15, within about 10 to 12 years, it had shifted to, if you join NATO, we invade you. To now, even to today, where if you even talk about joining NATO, we invade you. Now, what has happened here is, there have been several things that happened, the bombing of Serbia and the detachment of Kosovo, that happened under Yeltsin in the 90s. But it was a huge humiliation for Russia. And Russia was like, how do you do this? You're saying you're upholding a rules-based order. What rule exactly are you upholding out here? Okay. Yeah. Sure, there was genocide, absolutely. But that doesn't give you the right to separate that country out. Okay. They went and regime changed Libya, even though the UN resolution was for a ceasefire. It was not for a regime change. They went and regime changed. They tried to regime change, in Libya. They did regime change in Iraq. They went in completely illegally without a UN authorization and regime changed there. Then there was the issue of the ballistic missile treaties and things like that, because what was happening was, when Iran's nuclear program came into focus, the Russians said, great, you want to do boost phase intercept of Iranian missiles because you think Iranian missiles threaten Europe. What we'll do is, the most natural route that an Iranian missile will take northwards is through Russia. So isn't it obvious that you set up your anti-ballistic missile defenses in Russia? It can be a joint program because we have a mutual treaty that we will not deploy anti-ballistic missile defenses. So what we'll do is, we'll jointly develop a system. It will be based out of Russia. It will give you security. It will also give us reassurance that it is not aimed at our missiles, because you can stop Iranian missiles, but you shouldn't stop Russian missiles, because that is mutual deterrence.
Okay.
The Americans said no. They withdrew unilaterally from the treaty, and you saw what happened.
Yeah.
Then came all the colored revolutions. Okay. So it was a lot of things happening simultaneously. You know, in Georgia, in Ukraine, Maidan, and things like that, which basically now Putin does not trust one word of what the West tells him, with good reason. He has very good reason not to trust a single word they say. Because they wrap it up very beautifully. The packaging, the sales packaging, is very good. But you know, at some point he would have to be extremely foolish to take them at their word ever again.
Yeah. As would like any non-Western country at this point, you know.
Correct.
But so I know that you said that you were surprised and a lot of your friends in Moscow were also surprised. But if you were to try and rationalize it, how do you rationalize what has happened in the 24 hours? Achha.
I don't. Look, the only explanation I'm getting is Putin hates democracy. Okay, weird. That's not a rationale.
Yeah.
A rationale is, what is the cost-benefit analysis of this? I am not hearing any good cost-benefit because, like I said, he would have achieved a demilitarization of Ukraine, or at least a neutralization of what's called a Finlandization of Ukraine 2-3 years down the line with, you know, focused pressure. He hasn't done that, and he's chosen something that's going to cause Russia a heck of a lot of pain in economic terms. I am... Nobody that I've spoken to in Moscow is also able to explain the situation to me. They fundamentally did not believe that this was going to happen. And you know why they did not believe it was going to happen was because they had never seen in Russian literature or in internal government documents any rationale for why this was a good thing. They'd never seen a you know, plan of how to evade sanctions, etc., etc., etc.
Yeah. Do you feel then, from a Russian perspective, do you feel that the maximum that Putin expects is sanctions? He doesn't expect any actual military confrontation with the West, which is why he's most likely taken this decision. And it's pretty much been echoed by what Biden has also said. Ke ye galat baat hai, nahi nahi, very bad. We'll
that is sanctions. Correct. I mean, look. Look, it's all sanctions. I think everybody agrees it's only going to be sanctions. But, you know, this is like that famous song, na? कि प्यार किया तो डरना क्या, प्यार किया कोई चोरी नहीं तो घुटघुट आहें भरना क्या, ये घुटघुट आहें भरना भी कोई जीना होता है क्या? Because that is what sanctions are, right? Now remember, Russia has a lot of cards to play. It can run the commodities market, the gas and the phosphate nitrates market, which determine food prices because of fertilizer and this and that. It can play havoc with those. It can play havoc with air routes because remember, most routes, east to west air routes, run over Russia and Ukraine.
Yeah.
Right. Do is to kind of stall east west air travel, is to declare the Black Sea a missile test zone for months on end, forcing everybody to kind of fly south over Turkey and Iraq and Iran and things like that. Even in the east, in the east west in the Pacific, declare a large missile test zone, and you cripple a lot of trans-Pacific airline routes as well. So there's a lot that they can do. They can cut off gas to Europe.
Yeah.
So if Europe decides that, you know, they're going to cut off gas pipelines or whatever, it will be self-inflicted. That's one thing Europe will never do, is cut off Russian gas. But if they say we're not going to pay for it, as in suspend the SWIFT payment methods for gas, Russia will turn off the gas. And people will die.
It's, and so I know the Kushal had made a very good point about China and Taiwan. And I want to come to that in a second, Kushal. But before that, Abhijit, I have one more question for you that... Biden has announced that there's going to be sanctions. Boris Johnson is saying there's going to be sanctions. Other countries in US, in EU are
Biden
saying there's going to be.
हम कड़ी निंदा करते हैं.
कड़ी निंदा करते हैं. राजनाथ सिंह बन गए हैं रातों रात. But what? How much of an effect do sanctions really have? Like, how much have they been able to cripple what Iran has been able to do in the Middle East over the last 5 or 6 years? How much have the sanctions really affected that?
Look, it's a Pyrrhic victory. Iran has been able to do a lot but at huge cost to itself. Okay, it's people can't travel. There's perpetual insecurity. The economy is completely criminalized, and because it is a black economy, etc., etc. And a black economy, because it's fungible, leads to other kinds of crime. So you'll see the same thing happen with Russia as well. It's not a good place to be under sanctions. Can you do a lot? Yes, you can. You can do a lot under sanctions. The problem is it changes the very nature of society.
Kushal, you had a very good point about, China and Taiwan. So I want
to... Kushal kya bolega? Wo kala hai. Wo kala hai. Wo Chinese nahi hai. Usko iske bare mein pata nahi hai.
Yeah. Not allowed to say anything about Russia. White country mein kale log kuch nahi bol sakte.
This is a very important question. Finally, to all those people who believe in Aryan invasion and Aryan migration, which side are you on? Because wo jo South Russia aur Ukraine ka area hai, abhi Aryavart ke bare mein tum decide karo. Aryavart kaun sa hai? Ukraine technically Aryavart hai.
Aryavart pe attack
technically Ukraine hai, Aryavart. So all those people who are against Ukraine, you are all haters.
But remember, I am fair, therefore I am actually Ukrainian. Exactly. Whereas Kushal is dark. He's a native savage that my ancestors came and colonized.
And gave birth to me, essentially. After that,
gave birth to you.
But I did have to, on a serious note, I did have 2-3 questions. So I'm not trying to make an apples and oranges comparison, but so 3-4 points I had, and I don't have opinions, but I have questions. So question number one, what does this do to Pax Americana? I know it's a little premature to make any grand, sweeping statements about Pax Americana, but how much of Pax Americana is diluted with this, and how much of, the Chinese age... So that was point number one. What does this do to Pax Americana, and how much of a piggyback does this provide to China? Now, because China could say ki abhi dekho ye log Afghanistan se nikle, so Putin ne abhi ye kiya Ukraine mein. Now, do we go ahead and do this in Taiwan? Now, I know geographically, both the areas are different. So, the military context is different. I get all that because I do try to follow as much as I can. So, Taiwan is not as easy. But what scares me, and this is something that we, just before we went online, I was asking Abhijit. Look, Taiwan and China together pretty much make up for most of the chip manufacturing in the world. Now, if Taiwan is taken over by China. देखो China ना take over करके भी आधी से ज़्यादा तो Taiwanese manufacturing को चूस ही लेता है. वैसे भी indirectly चूस रहा है. मगर अगर वो direct control कर लेता है. Did you see the statement by the Chinese? You know the Ukraine and Russia case is different. Taiwan was always a part of China. उन्होंने बोल दिया. उन्होंने कितना nonchalantly बोल दिया कि नहीं ये तो हमारा ही part था. तुम क्या nonsense बात कर रहे हो? So this was point number two. What does it do to that? And point number three. Why are people mad at India? Abhijit, what did India do?
No. Look, who when you say people are mad at India, who is mad at India? Ek do think tank ke tatpunji hai. Are Bruno to ek hai, par baki ke bhi log hai jo Indians hai, jo think tank ka chakri karte hai America mein, jo ye bol rahe ho, India should stand up and be counted. Kaya ka be counted rahe?
Yeah.
Hai? Bruno is not...
Who the hell has ever counted themselves for India? Ye to bata do.
So Bruno is not the be-all and end-all. The Indian Americans in D.C., they are saying this because unka local relevance, they have to seem to be posturing with their adopted country.
Yeah.
And so they have to posture and, criticize India about this. पर उनकी कौन सुनता है? I mean, वो आके मुठ मारे या सुसु करे हमारा क्या लेने देना उधर?
And speaking of उनकी कौन सुनता है कि अगर discussion हो ही रही है, I want to talk about the unluckiest guy on the planet. इमरान खान द बिगेस्ट बेगानी शादी में अब्दुल्ला दीवाना वी हैव एवर सीन ऑन द वर्ल्ड स्टेज. साफ साफ रशिया जा रहे भीख मांगने के लिए उसी समय.
देख भाई, देख देख, हर हक बनती है रूस जा, पर उधर जाके बोल ओह आई हैव लैंडेड हियर इन एक्साइटिंग टाइम्स. क्या चूतिया है यार तू,
ये बहुत बड़ा वाला है. बहुत बड़े वाला है. इट्स ऑलरेडी यू नो बोल्स्टरिंग द स्टेलर इमेज ऑफ पाकिस्तान ऑन द ग्लोबल स्टेज. इट्स फैंटास्टिक. डू यू थिंक दैट यू नो पीपल आर सेइंग कि उसके विजिट को देख के लोग चिढ़ जाएंगे एंड द ईयू एंड नेटो एंड अमेरिका इज गोना बी यू नो पाकिस्तान इज गोइंग टू गेट इनटू ट्रबल विद दोस कंट्रीज. डू यू थिंक दैट्स एक्चुअली गोइंग टू हैपन?
नो. Nobody gives a shit about Pakistan. So Pakistan's not going to get into trouble with anyone. See, there's the joy of being somebody ka tatta.
Yeah.
Yeah. So when, say for example, jab Sham Sharma ne uske saath badtameezi ki, mere ko bahut thes pahuncha. पर जब श्याम शर्मा कुशल मेहरा के साथ बदतमीजी कर रहा था, उसके टट्टे कैसे डिंगल 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 करके ये हो रहे थे उसके बॉक्सर के अंदर, कौन केयर करता है यार?
वो बात भी है ना. I just thought it was probably the funniest thing that came out of that whole episode yesterday. Oh, what an exciting time to be here.
I think he takes every situation and you know what a snafu, what the full form of snafu is?
What?
Situation normal, all fucked up. It was actually a military
acronym.
That's what Imran Khan is.
He hit a bit of a snafu in Russia. That's true. I do want to dig a little bit deeper into the question that Kushal asked, because we have seen this over a period of time now, and especially in the Indian context. I don't know what you guys think, and I want both of your opinions on this. In the Indian context also, we've seen ke global context mein to UN ke bahut sare failures hai. We've seen the UN be quiet on numerous regime change wars or operations or whatever, chahe Iraq ho, chahe South America mein ho, chahe Afghanistan ho, you know, whether it was the Kashmiri genocide, which they, you know, they said are internal matter hai, ye log apna dekhenge, we don't really care. On the Indian front as well, abhi hal mein hi, you have a UN agency tweeting on Twitter saying ki bhai jis aurat ke upar money laundering ke operations lage hain usko Indian government is oppressing. In terms of non-Western countries that aren't explicitly allied with the EU, with the UN, with America, you know, what faith should they have in that world order right now, when you have Biden saying ki acha, you know, providing a weak response to whatever Russia is doing? What kind of faith should a country like India have in that sort of order, when that order has no respect for India whatsoever, or Brazil or other countries for that matter?
Look, that order has a lot of respect for India. We can't judge that order just by what one agency in Geneva says.
Okay.
Right. And remember that UN Geneva is run by the special representative, specifically Irene Khan, a Bangladeshi woman who is herself accused of serious financial fraud.
Shabash.
Okay. So it's very obvious. So remember, that is an NGO handle. It's the UN's NGO arm doing it because they don't report back to their respective governments.
Yeah.
Okay, the governments themselves have no issues with India per se. I think we need to separate how governments think about India from how their press thinks about India. The governments generally realize that, you know, the press is prone to a lot of bullshit, which these people are not.
But you have, when you have organizations like the BBC, which is basically, you know, a government-owned or a government-run organization, and the kind of things that they do against India, you don't think there isn't a tacit approval from the governments? When
the BBC actually does a lot of crap that the Tories hate.
Yeah, that is true. That is fair.
Deutsche Welle does a lot of crap that the German government hates.
That's fair.
I think the issue here is, like, for example, Ashok Sven at Uppsala.
You go talk to
the Swedish government the moment you say, before you can finish saying Ashok Sven, all Swedes are very well behaved, you know, but before you finish saying Ashok Sven, they'll be like, fuck you. You go talk to the University of Uppsala, because I have lots of friends in Uppsala. You go to the University of Uppsala and you say Ashok Sven, and you know those university guys are like, because they're like, here's the asshole again. But if at the same time they will say, look, it is important. We realize he's an asshole. We realize he's a hot air windbag.
Yeah.
But academic freedom.
Yeah.
Okay. So we need to make that distinction.
Mm.
The problem here is that when the press writes something, an MEA official is taken to task by the PMO.
Mm.
And in order to protect himself, he says, sir, dekho, ye antarashtriya sazis hai. Sazis. Okay, so there is that. Then there is a case of clear and tacit direction provided by the government. Okay, so for example, what that commissioner for the ambassador for international religious freedoms tweeted about India.
Yeah.
That Rashad Khan or whatever he is, that was basically orchestrated by that woman Uzra Zia, who's a she's not a hijabi, she's the worst kind of fundamentalist. She's the non-hijabi fundamentalist. Okay, so we need to sit down and clearly identify what has foreign government footprints in it and what does not.
Kushal, is there anything to add from your end when it comes to sort of EU, UN, US, and the declining maybe faith in them among non-Western countries? Do you see that happening? Do you have anything different to add than Abhijit?
Well, I don't know. I think all I can say is now next time America goes to war, I think they're going to kill people by asking them of their gender identities. People are shooting at them. We're like, first tell me your gender. What are your preferred pronouns before
bomb I shoot? Pe BLM likha hai ki nahi likha hai?
Yes, that could be a very good strategy. I think people will commit suicide the moment they look at that. So I think that's America's secret weapon. Honestly, yaar, mera subject hai nahi.
Yeah,
yeah. I understand. Nahi padta. Mujhe itna malum hai. America side mein baitha hai. रशिया यूक्रेन में गया है, क्रूड $100 के ऊपर हो गया है, मेरा पेट्रोल महंगा होने वाला है.
यस, महंगा होने वाला है.
मुझे इतना मालूम है, उससे ज्यादा मुझे मालूम नहीं है. मैं एक्सपर्ट हूं नहीं इस विषय में.
डू यू थिंक दिस माइट प्रेसिपिटेट, यू नो, देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ कार कंपनीज यूएस में, जैसे कैलिफोर्निया ने तो बेसिकली मैंडेट किया हुआ है कि सारी गाड़ियों को इलेक्ट्रिक बनना है बाय
2030. अभिजीत, डू यू सी, बिकॉज अमेरिका इम्पोर्ट्स अराउंड 500,000 बैरल्स डेली और समथिंग, आई डोंट कोट मी ऑन दैट. सो डू यू थिंक दे विल नाउ गिव अ फिलिप टू फ्रैकिंग अगेन इन अमेरिका, कंसिडरिंग दिस न्यू अटैक बाय रशिया ऑन यूक्रेन, जस्ट टू गेट आउट ऑफ दिस ऑयल फियास्को?
लुक, दे विल हैव टू रिसॉर्ट टू फ्रैकिंग अगेन. I don't see any way out of it. Okay, because even their economy is not fully electrified.
Yeah.
It still operates a lot on petrol and stuff like that. So there is absolutely no way out of this.
Acha, tell me one more question I have, Abhijit, related to pasto gaadi nahi hai, best option. Gaadi chhod do. I have another question. This is again a question that a lot of people are asking. Okay, how come Putin pulls a stunt like this within a year of Biden becoming president? Whereas for 4 years of Trump's time, Putin was, you know, fairly well behaved. Why do you think this has happened? Some people are saying that's because Trump was a Russia puppet. Is that the truth, or is something else the truth?
See, if he's a Russia puppet, then this should have happened during his time, no?
That's what you think, yeah.
The thing, yeah. So clearly it wasn't. The thing was, Trump wasn't going to unnecessarily go on fingering the bear. This is like people who keep throwing stones at dogs on the street and then complain that the dog came in between. Trump was minding his own business. Kutte ne aake ek baar bhonk diya. He kept quiet. He ignored it. Yeah. Kuch nahi hua. Okay. Biden is that sara tatpujya incel chutia who is like, hey, mommy, mommy, main jakina, main patar maringa uspe. And go, da, 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 and kutte ne aake rung kar diya.
Kaat liya.
This is what happens.
Yeah.
So clearly, Trump was always trying to de-escalate. Biden was constantly trying to escalate. And mind you, the real tragedy of all of this is the Biden family made millions and millions of dollars out of this corrupt Ukrainian oligarch ecosystem.
Yeah.
Yes.
Right. If anyone was compromised, it was Biden.
Yeah.
Both to the Chinese and to the Ukrainians.
Yeah. So if I were to ask for your...
And don't forget, Ukraine played a role in the Steele dossier. Remember, they were asked to provide certain things and whatnot for the Steele dossier.
And I mean, so you have all of those things that kind of add up a little bit, right? Agar, if you are Russia... Yeah. I'm not saying that this full-scale invasion of a country is bloody justified in any way. But if you're Russia, you have a reason to feel very wary of what is going on with Ukraine, Ukrainian politicians, and top American politicians.
You have a right to be wary.
Hmm.
You do not have a right to be overcome by your emotions. And sadly, 100%. That is what has happened out here. I think emotionality got the better of Putin this time. I'm actually.
What is he emotional about? Like a guy that is not generally, you don't associate, you know, over emotional with a guy
sense,
like Putin.
A sense of history. If you listen to his speech 2-3 days back, it was just the sheer sense of history playing out. Right. He's gone into a very dark place.
Yeah.
And that worries me because for me, I don't think anybody on earth could have said Putin was stupid.
Yeah.
Xi Jinping is stupid. I think everybody agrees that Xi Jinping is stupid, which is what makes him dangerous. But Putin was less dangerous because he was not stupid.
Yeah.
But this is an intensely stupid move.
Hmm. What is... So before we move off of this topic, what do you think is the end game for this? Like if you had to, in your professional opinion, if you had to give a prediction, what happens as a result of a full-scale invasion of a sovereign country by another country happening, you know, playing out in public in the social media age? What do you think is the end game of this?
There's going to be crippling sanctions, which is going to massive inflation in the West, in India as well. Which is going to stoke a lot of social tensions across in Europe, in America, in India, in Africa, everywhere. in Ukraine, what's going to happen is Putin is either going to kill off most of the politicians or imprison them for life.
Yep.
Install a puppet government, have a sham election and have it validated and then withdraw. In which case the rationale for those sanctions goes away. And after a point of time, unable to deal with the social unrest because of those shocks, Europe will look at ways of starting to undo those sanctions.
Really? With the status quo intact?
Well, the status quo would not be intact because Russia would have withdrawn. There would be a puppet government in Ukraine.
Okay.
But it would no longer be under Russian occupation. There would have been an election in Ukraine.
An election, yeah.
So it's very important that we understand that. I personally don't think those sanctions will go away very early because I think we assume that common sense directs decisions, whereas what we're seeing is common sense seldom directs decisions. There would be a cabal in the US that would still need to maintain Russia as the enemy in order to survive. It's a very powerful cabal. It's the same cabal that put up Ukraine to all this shit. Which might be okay with the social stress that brings about, because identity politics and things like that plays to their strengths. So I honestly don't know. Let's look at what the sanctions are tomorrow. Then we'll have a better grasp on what's happening.
And for India, like, do you think that this puts India in a very precarious situation in terms of, like, does India, do you feel like they have an obligation to sort of side publicly with one side?
We have no obligation to anyone. Please remember, when Pakistan did the same thing to us, ye sab chutiye chup rahe. Yes. इन सब चुतियों ने आके इक्वेट किया अग्रेसर और अग्रेसी को और जब हम पे टेररिस्ट और ये सब होते टेररिस्ट अटैक और ये सब होते रहा वो सब पाकिस्तान को कभी भी कंडेम नहीं करते थे ठीक से ठीक है ना दे वोंट क्लासिफाई देम एज सब स्टेट एक्टर्स दे क्लासिफाई देम एज नॉन स्टेट एक्टर्स ओके सो आई हैव जीरो सिंपथी फॉर देम रिमेंबर यूक्रेन जॉइंड इन कंडेमिंग इंडिया when we exploded our new, when Vajpayee exploded nuclear weapons.
96 yeah. Mina.
96. Okay. Next. Ukraine isn't exactly the Virgin Mary out here, huh? They joined that illegal American invasion of Iraq.
Yeah.
So, India is under absolutely no obligation except for a cursory condemnation, saying we regret the breakdown of international norms, we urge restraint from both parties, and we immediately urge. Incidentally, something very interesting has happened. Putin has put out a statement, a very interesting statement. The Kremlin has put out a statement. Kremlin says Putin is ready to hold talks with the leadership of Ukraine to discuss the country's neutral status and refusal to host foreign military installations on its territory. Should Kiev be ready for such talks?
Interesting.
So he's basically saying, I will defang and castrate you by force.
Yeah.
Or you can do it in a way that's without anesthesia, or you can do it in a way that you choose with anesthesia slowly to your own liking.
Yeah.
I don't think Zelensky is going to accept that offer. Now, understand this. If Zelensky accepts that offer, it will be conditional. The Soviet, the Russian withdrawal will be conditional on all the sanctions going, because he has not disrupted Ukraine's sovereignty. But he will ask for cast iron guarantees where Ukraine will declare neutrality and declare that it will never join NATO. He might still achieve his objective. So I was very intrigued by this, because I never thought of this angle till right now. And he'll say, okay, we're stopping all military action. Zelensky, you signed the fucking dotted agreement, and if you break your neutrality, then Russia will have a legal right to invade you.
Yeah.
Okay. So that is fantastic for the Russians. So this might actually be a way out. Maybe Putin was counting on this. I don't know.
How foresighted, you know, how important does that decision, Kushal, become of the Vajpayee government to become a nuclear power? I mean, 20, 25, whatever, how many years down the line, you are seeing it pay dividends in such a massive way. And, you know, I remember back then, jab is tarah ki cheeze ho rahi thi, you had world powers who were like, kya zarurat hai? Why is India doing something like this? Why is India...
America ne bhi hum pe sanction dala tha na tabhi.
Didn't Bill Clinton say, why are they doing this? Why are you antagonizing the whole world like this? Yeah, this is
why are you doing this? To cho, tumhari harkatein dekho.
Sala, shayad Vajpayee ji ko pata tha ki 25 saal ke baad ye aadmi aane wala hai. Biden, budau. ये बुढ़ाव साला सबको पनौती बनेगा।
बाइडेन का तो वैसे हाईली कंडेमनेबल मीम है, ये देख कहाँ गया
ये? अबे ये अलग से निकालो ना, डीएम शेयर कर रहे हो अपने।
ओ सॉरी, हाईली कंडेमनेबल बिहेवियर बाय मी,
हाईली कंडेमनेबल।
ये देखो, वो तो काला है, वो तो करेगा।
ये देखो
कुछ बिफोर द पॉडकास्ट,
आओ मेरे एक्सपर्ट ओपिनियन सुन लो मशीन। मुझे कुछ नहीं पता, ऑर्डिनेंस थ्रू आउट द पॉडकास्ट, ये सब तो ज्ञापन।
You've just been clickbaited. Clickbait कर दिया है आपके साथ। पूरी तरह से clickbait हो गया आपके साथ।
वैसे अश्नी ग्रोवर ना इससे थोड़ा गोरा है, ये थोड़ा काला है।
अच्छा। तो he is the गोरा पंजाबी, काला पंजाबी, the all shades of Punjab, you know, united colors of Punjab. Right?
We just met Abhijit and I during the weekend, and it was categorically and unequivocally proven who was the real kala and who was the
I reject this in its entirety. There were witnesses, and all the witnesses agreed that I was fairer than Blackie.
Fairer than so Blackie.
ये जिधर जाए ना मैं अपना हाथ ऐसे रखूँ उसके पास।
फ्रेम में होना।
भाइयों बहनों, हमारे प्रिय दर्शकों, आप क्या इस कलुए को बिलीव करते हैं? नहीं
को बिलीव करते हैं,
सबको पता है कि
मैं पूछना चाहता हूँ लोगों से,
एकदम गोरा
हूँ। किसको बिलीव
करेंगे? मैं देखो मैं हमारे प्रिय दर्शक, आप बिलीव कीजिए, मैं इन्वेडिंग आर्यन हूँ जिन्होंने आके आपका पूरा घर उजाड़ा था 4,000 साल पहले, और ये कलुआ है जिसका मैंने घर उजाड़ा था।
अबे इसने तो शाम ने तो अपने आप को खुद को ही निकाल दिया पॉडकास्ट से। शाम
क्यों निकाल दिया?
शाम तेरी लेने के शाम तेरे को लेने के चक्कर में खुद को निकाल के चले गया पॉडकास्ट से।
देखो किसने लात मारी यार, आप कोई लात मार
दी,
अपने आप कोई लात मार दी लगता है गलती से। या तो भाई आर्यन होमलैंड वाले को बिलीव करोगे जो घोड़े पे बैठ के स्टेपी से निकल के आए थे, या फिर आप यू नो यहाँ के नेटिव को बिलीव करोगे? तो यू हैव टू डिसाइड। काला लाइव्स मैटर बोल रहा है, काला लाइव्स मैटर बोल रहा है।
मुद्दे पे आ गए लोग,
मुद्दे पे आ गए लोग,
उछड़ी के मीम रिव्यू करो।
देखो आप मैं
हाँ बोल, बोल
मैं नहीं रह सकता मैं रिव्यू के लिए, मेरे
को मैं रिव्यू में ये नहीं रह सकता, इसको जाना है, बहुत बिजी है, ही हैज टू डू व्हाइट पीपल थिंग्स, सो द ब्राउन एंड द ब्लैक पीपल विल कंटिन्यू। या
सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड विद द मीम।
सो तुम सब काले 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 लोग अपने काले काले करतूत करो, और मैं जा रही हूँ।
ओके चल बाय,
बाय बाय,
टाटा
बाय बाय। सब लोग अभिजीत को बाय बाय बोलो। हाँ, अच्छा आपको मैंने जो वीडियो वाले भेजे पहले वीडियो वाले शेयर करो, फिर मैं देखता हूँ मेरा कंप्यूटर क्या करता है।
तेरा कंप्यूटर भी हराम जाता है,
तो कंप्यूटर है। अरे यार इधर रिकॉर्ड टाइम है भैया, कसम से मैंने इतनी लंबी डिलीवरी कभी भी नहीं देखी, ये साला 2 हफ्ते लग जाते हैं।
अरे तेरे को मेरे साथ क्या भद्दा मजाक हुआ
क्या?
चलो पहले ये मीम ही लगाते हैं, मीम रिव्यू का वो लगा दे तू पोस्टर स्क्रीन पे।
हाँ लगा रहा हूँ मैं।
ये क्या घटिया।
वॉल्यूम डालो।
सादगी
कितना सपोर्ट करते हैं खुद का दहेज,
मेरी जोड़ी का ना कोई तोड़ से, कहूँ माने चाहिए गति तेरे वाले की साद।
क्या ये इसके नीचे कमेंट देख भाई, पिछवाड़ा हिला के एक वीडियो क्या वायरल हुई, बंदी अब हर 2-3 वीडियो के बाद वैसी ही वीडियो अपलोड कर रही है, लेकिन बंदी करेगी भी क्या, आजकल हम जैसे ठरकी भी ज्यादा पड़ गए।
ये बात भी सही है। और पिताजी भी खुश है, लड़की अपना दहेज खुद ही कमा रही है।
what is happening?
ये देखो मैं सबसे गोरी हूँ. शाबाश मैडम, मैडम भी आ गई. ऐसे इंडिपेंडेंट होना चाहिए. इंस्टाग्राम पे जाके अपना दहेज खुद कमाइए. वेरी गुड.
एक सेक्युलर है जिसने ये ट्वीटा है.
सेक्युलर ने डाला है.
किताब खुला है लेकिन फोन चल रहा है. इनके पिताजी भी देखिए, इनके पिताजी भी यहाँ पे बैठे हुए हैं. इनसे हम थोड़ी सी बातें करते हैं. जैसे कि आप लग रहा है आप सीनियर भी हैं सबसे, पिताजी भी हैं, तो हमें ये बताइए कि इन लोग को एक कहते नहीं कि पढ़ाई वढ़ाई करो.
बहुत समझाता हूँ कि पढ़े लेकिन पढ़ते ही नहीं है.
ये बड़ी अच्छी बात कही है.
पढ़ाई नहीं करते तो बेटा कौन है आपका? ये जो बेटा नहीं है कोई, मैं खुद तैयारी कर रहा हूँ. ये मोटिवेशन मिलता है कि क्यों कुछ भी हो,
मैं खुद पढ़ाई कर रहा हूँ पिताजी.
पता है
पिताजी JNU स्टूडेंट है बेसिकली. पिताजी ने सबसे ज्यादा स्पिन कर दिया. पापा तो JNU स्टूडेंट निकले. पापा JNU में अपना 7th ईयर कर रहे हैं इस समय पर. इसीलिए जब जब टीवी डिबेट्स में जाते हैं तो उनको छात्र बुलाया जाता है. JNU स्टूडेंट
बारिश थी कष्ट हुआ उसके लिए धन्यवाद.
आज बारिश थी आपको कष्ट भी हुआ होगा इसके लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद.
इसका रोज क्या है भाई, ये हर हफ्ते एक भी जरूर भेजता है हमको ये आदमी.
एक तरफ ये अपना भाई एक तरफ.
मुझे ऑनेस्टली लगता है कि राहुल गांधी सीरियसली मीम रिव्यू देखता है क्योंकि हर हफ्ते एक मीम जरूर भेजता है वो रिव्यू करने के लिए. बारिश हुई आपको कष्ट हुआ उसके लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद.
बस ऐसे ही सड़ते रहो मरते रहो तुम लोग, मेरे को बहुत अच्छा लगता है.
माफी मांगना चाहिए था तो धन्यवाद बोल.
ये क्या लिखा है? अनुराग पार्टी, सांप भी मर जाए लाठी भी ना टूटे. रोहिण सिंह, रोहिणी
ना रहेगा बांस ना बजेगी बांसुरी. अखिलेश इन रैली.
हमारे नौजवानों वो कहावत याद है कि न रहेगा सांप और न बजेगी बांसुरी. जब सब कुछ बिक जाएगा
दोनों
तो बताओ नौकरी कहाँ होंगे, रोजगार कहाँ होंगे.
न रहेगा सांप कहाँ से आ गया, न रहेगा बांस.
सांप भी मर जाए और लाठी भी न टूटे एंड ना रहेगा बांस ना बजेगी बजेगी बांसुरी. दोनों को मिक्स कर दिया सर ने. सर इज
जीनियस निकले.
सर इज वेरी फैंटास्टिक. सर नए नए ईजाद कर रहे हैं हमारे. किसी ने डाला पप्पू ऑफ यूपी. ये पप्पू ही है सर.
साला जिसका रियल लाइफ में पप्पू नाम होएगा उसका कितना नाम खराब हो गया.
इसका क्या बेइज्जती हो रखी है. ये किसने डाला है? ये इंटरप्रेट ने डाला है ना आई थिंक.
हाँ.
Hey there, brother. Do you have time to talk about Jesus Christ today? Oh, you're dead? Oh, okay. Well, you have yourself a blessed day.
Okay, you too.
You must. Do you have time to talk about Jesus Christ today? Oh, you're dead? Oh, okay. Well, you have yourself a blessed day.
Okay, you too.
You must.
आपके भी दरवाजे पे कोई आए कभी बोलने के लिए तो ये उंगली कर देना उसको भी ऐसे ऐसे. सॉरी. और उसके बाद जब पादरी बोले ओके हैव अ गुड डे तो बोलना ओके यू टू ब्रदर यू नेक्स्ट टाइम.
ये हरामी
ग्रेट ग्रेट बहुत सही है.
एक मिनट. ये कुशल का बचपन है. दिस इज बाय अब्बा का हारमोनियम. काम कुशल अंटिल यू से आई एम सेक्युलर.
अरे तो याद है मैं है नहीं है. मैं कल कहाँ गई? लाला दी माता.
गलत टाइम पे धोखा दे दिया। दोबारा स्टार्ट करो, दोबारा रिफ्रेश करो इसको।
ये एक्चुअली मैं ही हूँ।
मदद चाहिए। इतने प्यार से बोलता है बच्चा।
ये तो सेम वापस आ गया है।
अच्छा, दो बार भेज दिया होगा मैंने गलती से। बचपन का वीडियो डाल दिया किसी ने।
खोल यार, ये तेरा रेडिट क्यों नहीं खुलता, इतना स्लो क्यों है?
सब चीज स्लो है आजकल दुनिया में।
नहीं यार,
स्लो कर रखी है।
तेरा रेडिट सटिया गया।
मेरा रेडिट साला, रेडिट कौन सा वीडियो है? मैं अभी खोला,
अभी दिखा। फाइनली सॉल्व।
क्या क्या सॉल्व?
दिस इज बाय द अंडरस्कोर चियोनमा, पता नहीं क्या इसका मतलब है।
द अमित शाह मिस्ट्री फाइनली सॉल्व।
हाँ, देखते हैं।
ए, सफेद कपड़ा। ओ ओ, ए,
नकल का राज लेता हूँ तेरा ही नाम लेता हूँ, ये तूने
सफेद कपड़ा। सफेद कपड़ा, अभी पता चला अमित शाह किससे बात कर रहे थे।
अमित शाह मिस्ट्री फाइनली
सॉल्व। देखो, अभिजीत मेरा बुर्का चुरा के भाग गया।
मेरे लिए नया खरीद तो इतने दिनों से मैं ही जा पा रही हूँ।
अभिजीत मेरा बुर्का चुरा के भाग गया।
रवीश, ये है सटायर सारथी का। रवीश मारेगा इसके बाद।
रवीश मारेगा। अरे, एनडीटीवी की बहुत बेइज्जती हुई है इस हफ्ते।
तो जो एक छवि बन गई है भाजपा की, कि वो सिर्फ जो है ठाकुरों की पार्टी है, जो उच्च जातियों की है, ऐसा नहीं है क्या?
नहीं, वैसा नहीं है। काम जो भी अच्छा करेगा तो उसमें जाति पाति का मतलब नहीं। हमारा देश आगे जा रहा है, हम देश का सोचे ना। हम अपना व्यक्तिगत विश्वास नहीं कर रहे, अपना हम देश का सोचे। हम देश का सोचेंगे, अगर देश का अच्छा होगा तो हमारा तो होने वाला ही है।
इतना दुख, इतना दुख।
सैड लाइफ,
दुख दर्द पेन पीड़ा जो बोलते हैं ना, वही हुआ है बेचारे के साथ। Oh my God. रवीश मारेगा।
लास्ट है अभी मिमी।
रवीश मारेगा। ये किसने भेजा है?
एक मिनट, ये भेजा है फन हिस्टोरियन 4066।
अच्छा, शी डिडंट वांट मी ऑन हर वेडिंग कार्ड। This is my favorite one. She didn't include me on her wedding card. Now I'm on her vaccination.
मर जा तू. अभी मैं तेरे वैक्सीन सर्टिफिकेट पे आ गया
हूँ. अब तो जब भी वैक्सीनेशन कार्ड दिखाओगी मेरी फोटो दिखेगी तुमको, डार्लिंग. सही है, बिल्कुल, ये बिल्कुल सही डाला. ओके, मैं कुछ फोटोज भी हैं, मैं फोटोज भी शेयर कर देता हूँ. किसी ने, मैं वीडियो मीम दिखाने से मैं थोड़ा डर रहा था कि कहीं मेरा कंप्यूटर अगलपंती ना करे फिर से, बट लेट्स सी. ये नॉनसेंसिकल नीमो ने भेजा डाला था, शी आई लव सेंसिटिव गाइज हु केयर अबाउट LGBTQ राइट्स, वीगन्स एंड अदर स्टफ, मी वेज वेज होमो
होमो बेस्ट वेज.
अरे हिंदुस्तानियों का जवाब नहीं है भैया, कसम से. अरे ये देखा कि नहीं यार कुशल, मेरे को आपका रिएक्शन चाहिए इस पे. दिस इज अंशु शर्मा ने डाला है, राइट विंग एंड लेफ्ट विंग आफ्टर सीइंग मुनव्वर फारूकी एंड कंगना रनावत वर्किंग टुगेदर इन लॉकअप शो, दोनों साइड की फटी पड़ी है. दोनों साइड की लगी पड़ी है, ये दोनों साले दोगले निकले. देखा आपने इसके बारे में? Have you heard about this?
नहीं, मैंने नहीं देखा ये.
Apparently, कंगना रनावत एक शो में काम कर रही है जिस शो में मुनव्वर फारूकी को भी रोल मिला है, तो both of them will be working together. दोनों साथ में मिलके एक ही शो प्रमोट कर रहे हैं, तो साल भर गाली दो उसके बाद साथ में बैठ के पैसे कमाओ. वेरी नाइस, वेरी नाइस. और क्या क्या भेजा है भाई, देखता हूँ मैं भी. ये किसी ने भेजा था हमको, मैंने बोला था कि ये मैं शेयर करूंगा इस पे अपने मीम रिव्यू पे. ये अर्थ फेस्टिवल में जब ये लोग गए हुए थे, तो कमेंट सेक्शन देखो, मीम स्ट्राइक ऑन अर्थ फेस्टिवल. शिकारी चारबका पॉडकास्ट, नीचे देखो लिंक स्वरूप.
अबे हराम जादो, साले जी वाले कभी नेक्स्ट टाइम बुलाएंगे नहीं मेरे को.
साला जी वाले भी सोच रहे होंगे चल क्या रहा इधर. ये देखो, ग्रेट टू सी चारबका महर्षि इज हियर,
फुल टाइम मीम रिव्यू जॉब.
My man Kushal is a completely different guy when he steps out of Shyam Sharma show pod. You want to see the real Kushal? Go watch those pods. Gandu Shikari bilkul professional ho jata hai dusron ke samne. This is fantastic yaar, maza aa gaya.
Bolo kya ho raha tha, Abhijit pehle live gaya tha. Abhijit shayad फ्राइडे को, तो अभिजीत को शायद फ्राइडे को था या सैटरडे, नहीं सैटरडे को मेरा बाद में था शायद, या सेशन मेरे को याद नहीं है. अभिजीत का सेशन चालू है, लाइव कमेंट से बर्बाद हुए पड़े. मेरा लाइव सेशन चालू होता है, उधर जाके लोग डोनेट टू कुशल वेराइट ICICI लिख रहे हैं. मैंने अभिजीत को बोला हमको कभी कोई बुलाएगा नहीं वापस.
जी वाला बोलेगा सर इनको एक ही पैनल में डाल दो, एक ही बार में इनका प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व हो जाएगी, अलग अलग पैनल में मत डालो, बहुत गालियां पड़ती है. ये डाला है राजवीर 4128 ने रेडिट पे. Why Russia wants to attack Ukraine? What did Ukraine do? Can anybody explain in simple words? Ukrainian president forwarded your anti-CAA dance and songs to Putin. एक औरत की वजह से वर्ल्ड वॉर 3 हो गया यार. एक औरत की डांस के वजह से साला वर्ल्ड वॉर 3 हो गया यार. हद बेइज्जती है.
ये अच्छा था किसी ने भेजा.
हाँ
ये रुक, कभी तेरे को बताता हूँ. किसी ने ट्विटर पे भेजा, ब्रेकिंग न्यूज, ध्रुव राठी की वीडियो देखने के बाद डिसाइड होगा कि यूक्रेन का क्या करना है व्लादिमीर पुतिन.
जब तक दुग्गल साहब नहीं बोलेंगे तब तक कैसे होगा. तब तक कैसे होगा, कैसे डिसाइड करेंगे हम लोग सर. अरे यार फैंटास्टिक, फैंटास्टिक. और क्या है भाई. और भी मीम्स है, रुको दो तीन और मैं निकालता हूँ. अरे ये एक अभिजीत के लिए भेजा, बड़ा सही शेयर करना पड़ेगा, रुको. ओके ये देखो वर्नैक्युलर मीम डाला था अभिजीत के लिए, लेकिन बेचारा अभिजीत तो चला गया. पोस्टेड बाय मैका नीरव, तू गोली भरता रह जाएगा और कोई मेरा गेम बजा देगा. साले बाइडेन मदद कर साले. किसी ने बड़ा अच्छा कमेंट डाला था ट्विटर पे, मैं भूल गया किसने बोला था, बट किसी ने बोला था कि यार पता है रशिया ने इस टाइम पे क्यों इन्वेड किया यूक्रेन को, क्योंकि और अमेरिका में रात के 8 बज चुके हैं और बाइडेन सो रहा होगा, अगले 12 घंटे तक नहीं उठेगा. अगले 12 घंटे तक सर जी नहीं उठने वाले. ये डाला है स्नूपीज 6471, तू भी यहां मेरी तरह पोलियो ड्रॉप्स पीने आया है. करेगा भी ऐसा काम, उसको बुलाया है पोलियो पोलियो का प्रचार करने के लिए, सारा पोलियो ड्रॉप पीने आ जाता है. बोलता है जब तक मैं प्रोडक्ट को टेस्ट नहीं कर लेता मैं प्रमोट नहीं करता.
चार बूंद जिंदगी के राहुल का.
फैंटास्टिक यार, गुड जॉब, गुड मीम. ये देखो, दिस इज माय फेवरेट वन. ये कच्चा बादाम मीम पता नहीं आपको पता है कि नहीं, बट लोगों को पता होगा. ये किसी ने भेजा है, केडी लाडवाल कॉज ऑफ वर्ल्ड हंगर कच्चा बादाम आफ्टर 1 night इन वाटर. आफ्टर 1 night इन वाटर. कोई भेजो यार अभिजीत को. कोई भेजो बेचारे यार, ये सब वेरी गुड मीम एज वेल. ओह शिट मैन,
एंड ये अच्छा वीडियो था, ये कसम एआईएम के टकले की ने भेजा था. ये हाउ इज विक्रम संपत फीलिंग राइट नाउ. विक्रम को भेजूंगा मैं.
झुंझर के सर पे हमारे चमेली, झुंझर के सर पे,
ये मेरे को व्हाट्सएप कर, मैं ट्वीट करूंगा. ये
झुंझर के सर पे हमारे चमेली, कहां राजा भोज कहां गंगू तेली, कहां राजा भोज कहां गंगू तेली.
विक्रम ने सही काम किया इन लोगों को,
एकदम सही किया है, यही करना है इन लोगों के साथ. यार ये डेफेमेशन नहीं है तो और क्या है? इट्स अ क्लासिक ब्लडी डेफिनेशन ऑफ डेफेमेशन, और क्या हो सकता है ये. लास्ट आज का देखो, ये राजवीर 4128 ने भेजा है, इतना कमीना मीम है. देखो, नाउ अभिषेक बच्चन कम्स टू सपोर्ट ईच अदर. इतने कमीने लोग हैं यार. इतने कमीने लोग हैं.
ये वाला देखा कि नहीं तूने? ये वाला
यार, हैप्पी एंड अप राजवीर, हैप्पी एंड अप, गुड जॉब यार.
ये वाला देखा कि नहीं तूने?
क्या नहीं, मैंने नहीं देखा.
बर्बाद.
मैं भी पर्दा करूंगी, मैं
भी पर्दा करूंगी.
मुस्लिम कौम की बेटी हूँ
क्या है क्या कर रहे हो
मैं पर्दा करती हूँ
चैनल ब्लॉक कर अरे भगवान ए भगवान इतने कमीने लोग सोशल मीडिया पे मजा आ गया गुड जॉब यार गुड मीम रिव्यू अगेन फिर से आज अच्छा वाला भेजा तुम लोगों ने अभिषेक बच्चन जॉइंट यार वो दैट वाज माय फेवरेट प्रोबेबली फैंटास्टिक
बेसिकली देख मैं ना एक ही चीज में समराइज करना चाहता हूँ कि हमारा एम ऑफ श्याम शर्मा शो क्या है
हाय राम
ये हमारा एम है श्याम शर्मा शो का ये है हमारा एम
उंगली उंगली करना काली
ये हमारा एम है हम और कुछ नहीं करते
हमारा एम है उंगली करना दैट इज आवर गोल
दैट्स ऑल
Oh my God. अच्छा देखते हैं अभी क्या कोई क्वेश्चन आए हैं क्या हमारे पास I'm sure there are some questions. Let's take a few of them. देखता हूँ क्या क्या भेजे हैं शिल्पा says I look forward to your podcast. Thank you Shilpa. Very happy you're able to join us every week. Shashank Shekhar is asking Do you think one nation, one election is possible? If it is, then is it actually required?
It's not possible because itne sare municipal elections hote hain aur ye sab hote hain. Now they can say they can keep three EVM machines and do that. But is it desirable is the question that we need to have a discussion about.
Yeah.
More than possible, I think you could pull it off. But is it desirable? It's something that I'm wondering about.
Yeah.
Because I think having elections at different time of the year has its own pulls and pushes, right? It has its own disadvantages and advantages, which in the long run tends to average out overall, which I think has its own charm, if you ask
me. One thing you would say that I think the big disadvantage I think people would say is that parties in that case are constantly in election mode. So certain decisions that they would be able to take otherwise, they do not often because of political considerations. I think you can make a very good case ke farm laws wapas isliye hue hain kyunki UP mein election aane wale the aur Punjab mein election aane wale the nahi hote to shayad wapas nahi hote farm laws
I don't know I think agar farm laws fir bhi wapas hote the considering the national security risk that would have become in Punjab I think wo still wapas hote the in my view and honestly In hindsight, I think just farm laws was a stupid decision, considering how many states have already gotten rid. I did not know the data. It's actually when I had gone on Amna and Khalid's podcast is when I started researching. And when I started researching, I was like, why the hell did we even do this? Because 19 states with already it is in immaterial. This was just a dhai state ka issue. And the government put so much at, at stake. But it's okay. Hindsight is always 2020 kind of a situation.
Abhinav Singh is asking ki I think this was a point that Abhijit made ke foreign governments should be separated from foreign media and often how foreign governments behave towards India might be different from how foreign media behaves towards India but Abhinav says what about dismantling global Hindutva And Abhi, there is another conference that's been organized, Genocide Prevention Conference that is being organized currently, that is being supported and actively promoted by US government-related agencies and organizations. What about, things like that? When you have government-funded agencies that overtly target India, tab kya kare?
Yeah, but see, my point is, why don't we look at positive building, right? Mm-hmm. Why? So, let's assume there is a Jaipur Lit Fest where they talk about weird things. So you have a Earth Lit Fest, right?
Yes.
If they write 10 books, you write 20 books.
Mein bhi shuru hua hai.
Yeah. So my whole point is that why do we have to obsess about what they are doing? Why don't we look at institutional building as a long-term goal? And yes, we can rebut their arguments. We rebut them in a scholarly manner. I mean, yeah. I think the way they have attacked Vikram Sampath is a classic case of how rattled they are.
Yes.
That now they know that there are scholars coming from the other side of the spectrum who may not die. You know, may not necessarily be right wing in the classical sense, but they're just not left wing.
Yeah.
Yeah. People like me, people like you, you know, who are, I mean, I'm very libertarian is a different issue, but the point is I don't toe the BJP line either.
Yeah.
Right. Abhijit doesn't toe the BJP line. You don't toe the BJP line, but we don't toe the left wing line.
Yeah.
So there are many things that has to be considered.
And I think another thing that needs to be said is that we don't, you know, I've always been very clear about this and very open about this on my show. There's a lot of YouTubers or people that make content of YouTube, for example, that will go out of their way to say ki yaar hum dekho puri tarah se neutral hai. We are making this content because BJP is fascist and we are neutral and we are supporting neutrality and secularism. But I've always been very open about this on my show ki dekho yaar mere ko BJP se jo bhi problem ho main inko jitna bhi gariya hu vote main inhi ko jaake deta hu. I go and vote for them. I'm very open about it. But because I go vote for them, mere ko, I feel like there's a personal, you know, I have a personal investment in that as well. Is that if the party doesn't think or doesn't live up to the values that the party espouses, I think I have the right to call them out on it.
Yeah, that's the whole point. I believe there is too much obsession with the other on social media. And it's not like only we do it. The left does it also. Not that the left doesn't.
Yeah.
It's just obsession. And I guess that's just the way social media functions, where you're constantly obsessing about what the ills or the... But what happens is the key difference until now between the left and the non-left was, while the left would obsess about the other, they would still do institutional building and they would do a lot of positive work also.
Yeah.
Now the other side has gone beyond the you know, Kisiani Billi Khamba Niche mode
section,
outrage mode se thoda thoda bahar nikal rahe hain, log books likh rahe hain, log books pad rahe hain, log content bana rahe hain. So that is where the focus should be. Even when you create a content, what kind of content are you creating? Are you really giving people new tools in terms of arguments? Or are you just outraging about what the other side is doing? That also needs to change. So I think there are some positives that are coming overall in the last 4 or 5 years. I see some great books coming out. I mean, there are so many things to read. Look at a guy like Nalin Mehta. He's not BJP.
Yeah.
He's a scholar, a proper scholar. But look, such a wonderful book he wrote. Now it's our job to read the book and write 200 essays out of that. That's on us.
Yes.
We don't do it. It's not their problem. That's our problem.
Yeah. Kushal, you said, Manthan is asking, Kushal, you said on Twitter some time ago that you are no longer a patriot. What does that mean?
I'm not a patriot. I was never a nationalist or a patriot. I was a civilizationalist. And I do believe that India as a nation has a civilizational responsibility to preserve and protect certain epistemic frameworks that have born out of India. And I do loosely believe in the concept of the nation state because it is a useful concept as of now. But as far as being a nationalist in the European sense, I'm not really one.
Don't you think even if you are a civilizationalist, it sort of does include nationalism under its umbrella?
No, it includes border territorial integrity. That I believe in as of now because of the neighborhood we are in. But
so in the European terms, do you mean nationalism as in like one culture, one language, that way?
Yes, that kind of a thing. I certainly am not that. And I also don't believe in this. I just think nations, look, I don't know how to put it. At the end of the day, nation states are fictions. They are. Whether we like it or not, they're fictions.
Yeah.
And I know they're a fiction. So sometimes I'm playing with the fiction, but it's okay. While civilizational, now somebody can come back to me, even civilizational state is a fiction. I know. I'm just picking one fiction over the other. That's all.
Yeah. Audrey Sharma is saying, Vikram ne mere tweet delete karwa diye, isliye mujhe dust ho gaya. Sham, baby, main bathroom se likh rahi hun. Yahan paper khatam ho gaya. Please paper de do, nahi to meri Aurangzeb wali kitab de do. Wo bhi aise hi potty saaf karne ke kaam aati. ये बहुत बड़े-बड़े लेजेंड हैं हमारे पॉडकास्ट में. Let us see. और क्या-क्या क्वेश्चन आया है यार?
क्वेश्चन बहुत कम थे यार.
बहुत सारे, lots of comments. lots of comments. Vikrant Nalkur is saying, what should India, how should India react to MCC protests in Nepal? Honestly, Vikrant, maine uske bare mein abhi, I haven't seen anything about it. So anything I will say will be basically talking out of my ass. What else? of course, aise log nahi honge hamare desh mein to kaise chalega kaam. Youth Ki Awaaz had written an article that Tarak Mehta Ka Ulta Chashma is a show inspired by Brahminical patriarchy because the minority Sikh, Parsi, Muslim characters are shown only eating and craving vegetarian food. Your view.
I don't Youth know if Ki Awaaz is chutia. That's my view.
This is it's something one of the best Ki shows. Awaaz. Yeah.
साला पूरी फैमिली बैठ के देख सकती हो शो इतना अच्छा शो है तुमको नहीं देखना ना देखो उल्लू के पटे सबके
एंड व्हाई इज इट सो वाइल्डली सक्सेसफुल इट इज वाइल्डली सक्सेसफुल इन इंडिया
इतना अच्छा शो है फैमिली शो है लोग सब साथ में बैठ के देख सकते हैं
वही है ना एनीथिंग दैट इज वाइल्डली सक्सेसफुल इज गोइंग टू हैव अ लिस्ट ऑफ डिट्रैक्टर्स एंड दैट्स बेसिकली व्हाट वी आर सेइंग व्हाट वी आर सीइंग विद तारक मेहता का उल्टा चश्मा एज वेल उसके ऊपर से उनका जो मराठी कैरेक्टर है वो अपने घर में साला वीर सावरकर की फोटो लगा के रखता है ऐसे ही पिछवाड़ा जाता रहता है लोगों का हां भीड़े 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 पीछे अपने दीवार पे हमेशा सावरकर की फोटो लगा के रखता है वो लोग जब भी ट्रिप पे जाते हैं तो जय वीर सावरकर के नारे लगाते हैं ऐसे ही देख के यूथ की आवाज की फट जाती होगी तो आर्टिकल नहीं लिखेंगे तो क्या करेंगे बेचारे लेट्स सी और कोई क्वेश्चन है कि नहीं है है कि नहीं है बाकी क्वेश्चंस यार देखो ये इंडिया क्या करेगा नीतीश कुमार ने पूछा एक सवाल कि मोदी जी क्या करेंगे अमित शाह क्या करेंगे वो तो ऑलरेडी अभिजीत ने बेसिकली वो सवाल आंसर कर दिया है कि व्हाट शुड इंडिया बी डूइंग
क्या करे और क्यों करे इंडिया yeah. क्यों करे ये भी तो क्वेश्चन बोलना चाहिए ना Why should India react to everything? India will react on its own time and on its own pace. ये लोग ने कौन सा react किया था? जब हमारे
और immediately react क्यों करना है? साले YouTuber थोड़ी हैं. Immediately थोड़ी react करने की जरूरत है. और क्या क्या है भाई? I'm trying to find if we have any others.
By the way, I just realized, I want to say, I did not realize, this is why I cut that video off, that Vikram Sampath and Audrey, I did not realize it had a caste slur in that. Abhi mujhe strike wo, kahan Raja Bhoj, I just realized, because where did I hear that? And then I was like, that's a caste slur. So before somebody else points that out, I think we should cut that part out of the video itself and we'll cut it out. I did not realize that.
ऐसे
गाने बना दिए थे
अरे उसके ये तो फिर भी है उसके पहले भी इधर देयर इज 70s 80s बॉलीवुड में तो और भी मान मान लिरिक्स है
मेरे को अभी सडनली स्ट्राइक हुआ तो मैंने बोला व्हाइल वी आर एट ऑन द शो इटसेल्फ मैं क्लेरिफाई कर दूं
या
यू मेरे को कुछ तो गड़बड़ लगा इसके लिए तभी मैंने कट भी कर दिया उसको
या आई थिंक दैट्स फेयर ऑलराइट आई थिंक दैट्स ऑल द क्वेश्चंस वी हैव अनलेस वी सी एनी
मैं और ऊपर गया ऊपर जा रहा हूं ऊपर जा रहा हूं चैट में आई एम ट्राइंग टू कवर एज मेनी
या सेम बट आई डोंट सी एनी अदर क्वेश्चंस
मैं देख रहा हूं कुछ क्वेश्चन है नहीं
Yeah.
कुछ ऐसे क्वेश्चन है जिसका कोई आंसर है नहीं
I see somebody had asked what do you think of Upward यार देखो I support people making content I have no problems with people making content if there's a lot of people that come to me and they often say there are certain things that Upward publishes that I do not agree with on a personal level and people often come to me and say कि अच्छा आप हमको बोलो वील गो एंड रिपोर्ट आकाश बैनर्जीज वीडियो और वील गो एंड रिपोर्ट ध्रुव राठीज वीडियो एंड वील गो एंड रिपोर्ट करो इनको रिपोर्ट करके बैन करवाओ आई डोंट बिलीव इन दैट पर्सनली एट ऑल आई नो दैट देर आर अदर यूट्यूबर्स एंड देर आर अदर कॉन्टेंट क्रिएटर्स हु हैव मास रिपोर्टेड एंड डिलीटेड
मेरे साथ हुआ है
बाई अदर कॉन्टेंट क्रिएटर्स मेरे साथ ये हो चुका है ये स्ट्रिंग के साथ हो चुका है एलविश यादव के साथ इट्स हैपेंड टू अ लॉट ऑफ अदर कॉन्टेंट नॉट जस्ट right-wing content creators as well. This has happened to all kinds of content creators. This mass reporting going to YouTube because you have a big channel and throwing your weight around and saying ki ye chote channel ka video delete karwao. I've seen this happen. And I have suffered and a lot of other creators have suffered as a result of it. Aur main nahi chahta ki just for somebody speaking opinions that I do not agree with or that I might even find abhorrent at some point, that unko band karwa dena chahiye. Unless they are calling for violence, unless wo bol rahe ki idhar niklo, isko maro, ye karo, wo karo, bolne do unko. I will counter it on my own channel. We will counter it here on the podcast. I will counter it on my Instagram reels, whatever I do. Twitter pe hum log meme banayenge inke bare mein. So that is what I believe. I don't believe in silencing everybody. I believe everybody should have a voice. And as long as they're just using their voice to point out their opinions.
Upward should have a voice. Ashish should have a voice. Everyone, all of these people should have a voice. I don't agree with Ashish. I mean, there is no... I mean, my disagreement with the worldview of decoloniality and all that post-colonial studies worldview is very known now. But I think they should create as much content as possible and, you know, all the best to them and may the best idea win.
यार पहले हमारे पास प्रॉब्लम ये होती थी कि नॉन लेफ्ट से कंटेंट ही नहीं आता था. There was no content at all. Now at least there's content available. ठीक है, some content you like, some content you don't like. But at least there's content available. बनाने दो. The bad ideas will get weeded out. वो कहते हैं ना वो घुन में पिस जाते हैं. तो the bad ideas will get weeded out on their own. Then the good ideas will float to the surface. So
That's my whole take on this. You know, a lot of times people will ask me some weird questions on my podcast too. Like, why do you not do this? Arey, Baba, I don't agree with someone's worldview. Doesn't mean that person needs to be shut down. Yeah. I just don't agree with their worldview. I don't even need to be friends with everybody. There is enough space in this world for different ideas to blossom and bloom. And we should let all kinds of ideas come out. Now, and again, I'm not hiding it. I disagree with Ashish. I am not going to hide it. But I wish him well.
Yeah.
And I'll always disagree with him on this issue. And it's okay.
Yeah,
it's fine.
Exactly.
You know, if I meet him somewhere, I'll say hi, I'll be cordial, and that's how it should be.
Yeah.
And I'm sure that's how it will be from Ashish too. But the point is that you need to stop getting obsessed with, you know, what happens with a lot of viewers is like, you have to agree on everything, but why? Tum saale apne maa baap aur apni biwi bachcho se agree karte ho kya? Tum YouTuber se agree kara rahe ho.
Kushal is a libertarian. I am not a libertarian. Hum to ye podcast kar rahe itne samay se, even we don't agree with each other on everything.
Yeah, so many times.
Yeah, how does that bloody matter? What matters is that content is being created. And the non-left is finally creating not just content, the non-left is creating intellectual work. They're creating intellectual heft that is now rivaling the heft of whatever the non-left has leftists have created. It's leftists ki phati padi hai. Vikram Sampath ko attack kar rahe hai. Jai Sai Deepak ko attack karke usko jo recommendations de rahe the professors ko attack kar rahe hai. So this is happening for a reason. Is because finally after a long, long slumber, Kumbhkaran utha hai. So enjoy karo. While Kumbhkaran is awake, enjoy it and support them. Yeah.
See, again, now I read Sai's book, right? Mm. Disagree with his book completely. Disagree with that worldview completely. But if somebody else attacks Sai from the left, I'll not stand with them. I'll support Sai.
Yeah.
So a few days ago, some Patani viewer called Sai an Islamist on my podcast. I immediately corrected them. I was like, what nonsense is this? He's not an Islamist. Yeah. I disagree with him. It's okay. You can disagree.
Yeah.
I don't need to be, again, I repeat, I don't need to be friends with everyone. But as long as I can be consistent in my worldview where I want people to have a say in the discourse, I think it's fine. And we don't need to agree on everything. Abhijit and I are not going to agree on everything. Shyam and I are not going to agree on everything. And that's how the world is. And what we are trying to do through this podcast and through my podcast and through everything that we do, we are trying to promote different ideas. Now, you can take some ideas. You can reject some ideas. You don't have to agree with us. That's not the aim here. We are just trying to make you have a good time while we give you some interesting concepts.
Yeah, 100%. All right. So that's a good time for us to call it a day on today's podcast, guys. Thanks very much again for sending us the memes, for joining us for today's podcast. We made a conscious decision not to do any Russia-related memes, even though aap logon ne bheje the bahut sare. So if you didn't see them on today's podcast, it was for a reason. We don't know how the situation is going to unfold. So let's wait a while before we, you know, because actual real human lives are at stake. So let's wait a while before we, you know, maybe laugh at them or poke fun at these things. So just in case you didn't see your meme, that's why. Other than that, guys, again, you know where to support Kushal on the Charvaka podcast on YouTube. Become a member of this show and Kushal's show. Become a member of Patreon here and on Kushal's show. If you like today's episode, like, share, subscribe, press the bell icon so you get notified every time one of the podcasts arise. Because bahut logon ne live chat mein maine dekha hai, bolte rehte hain ki arey yar podcast shuru ho gaya, humko pata hi nahi chala. Make sure to press the bell icon so you'll be notified when the podcast goes live. And lastly, we are creating a Patreon for the show as well. Because we want to now continue to grow this show, continue to make this show, reach more and more people. So I think creating a team around this podcast that can help us grow this podcast, that can help us produce this podcast in a better way, I think is a right way to go about it. So we'll be creating a show podcast very soon as well. Wahan par merch bhi rahega. We'll be creating merch. That will be on the show podcast as well. So if you become a member, you can get access to some amazing merch there as well. So keep an eye out on that in the next couple of weeks. I think that should be good and ready to go. Other than that, yeah, we'll see you next week for the Thursday podcast. And until then, stay happy, stay healthy. We'll see you next week. Tata, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.